If you're anything like me, before you use a public toilet, you have to line it with a mountain of toilet paper. You pray that mountain doesn't fall in the water or the automatic flush doesn't go off before you sit, and if successful, well, you handle business. But is all that toilet paper really saving us from germs? We're talking to a doctor that specializes in infectious disease and preventive medicine to learn all about bathroom science and the germs we come in contact with daily.
A few years ago, I was in an airport, I want to say it was in Chicago, where they had these automatic toilet seat liners on some of the toilets. That reduces the ick factor, which is important to a lot of people, but really doesn't prevent the transmission of any bad germs.
Ready for a fun fact? On any given toilet, there's an average of 1,200 germs per square inch. The average human carries up to a kilogram of microorganisms, which are found on the skin, genitals, and the gastrointestinal system. So it's not out of the question to think organisms can be left on a toilet seat when someone gets up from handling their business. Human waste can contain microbes that carry viruses like salmonella and hepatitis A and E. If you think that's bad, studies have even found flesh-eating bacteria and E. coli on hospital bathroom toilet seats. Bacteria can live for days, depending on its type, location, and the humidity of the environment. Luckily for us, our bodies are covered with yeast and our own set of bacteria that works like a shield to prevent outside germs from getting in.
We have to remember that we don't live in a sterile world. We don't walk around with a microscope all the time, but if you went around with a swab, you know, and swab the environment, you would see kind of bacteria everywhere. So sometimes these bacteria, in small numbers, can survive long periods of time, days. They're not growing, they're just kind of sitting there. And yes, you could pick it up on your skin, but that doesn't mean you're going to get an illness from it. They usually don't penetrate the skin itself, unless, of course, you get a cut.
In most cases, your hands are the gateway to introducing germs to your body. Germs can be transported inside your body when you touch your mouth or rub your eyes. This is why it's always important to wash your hands after you use the bathroom or when you come in contact with bacteria. It's recommended that you scrub for 30 seconds and clean under your fingernails as well, because that's where bacteria hide. The first use of toilet paper dates back to 6 AD in medieval China. Before that, wealthy people wiped themselves with wood, lace, and hemp. As for poor people, they used rags, leaves, or their hands after pooping into a river. In ancient Rome, people used a sponge on a stick to wipe their butts. Then they placed it into a pail of vinegar so it would be ready for reuse. Toilet paper wasn't popularized in the US until 1857. While many opt for toilet paper as a source of protection, public health experts say it might be doing the opposite. You see, toilet paper is porous. It has tiny holes that small organisms can travel through. So when you line the seat with toilet paper, it only delays the time it takes for the bacteria to get to your skin. Toilet paper also acts as a method of transportation for bacteria to travel and spread on other surfaces. Then there's toilet plume, the spreading of bacteria that occurs when you flush the toilet.
So you have material in a bowl, in a sink, or a toilet, and then you move that material, the water, with energy. That's the flush. And you do get some aerosolization of the moisture. You can't see it, but it's there microscopically, and some of that can contain bacteria.
According to a 2005 study, when you flush, microorganisms can jump out of the toilet as high as 2.7 feet. Theoretically, those doodle particles can then spread from the toilet bowl to the toilet paper, so when you wipe, you're exposing yourself to the same germs, even the ones you are trying to avoid, by lining the seat with toilet paper. Grossed out, it gets even worse. If that bathroom has an automatic hand dryer, it can suck poop particles out of the air and push them back out every time it's activated. That means you're drying your hands with shit. The same thing can even happen at home. A 2012 study by Manchester University in England claims the average toothbrush has more than 10 million pieces of bacteria on them, including fecal matter. And you know where those particles come from? You guessed it, when you flush the toilet.
It may just be part of regular exposure to all of those germs. We don't really have to be all that obsessive.
Experts say that as long as you use toothpaste when you brush, those poop particles shouldn't harm you. If anything, these germs work to build your immune system, making it harder to contract any illnesses. The plight against dirty toilets is often fought by squatting or hovering, but experts warn against this as it can increase your risk for an infection. When urinating and hovering, your muscles and pelvic floor get tense, making it hard for urine to flow naturally. After years, this can make your bladder weak, and if you're not releasing all your pee, it can also increase your risk for a urinary tract infection. But as long as there's no liquid or visible fecal matter on the toilet seat, it should be okay for you to sit down bare bones. Just don't touch your eyes or your mouth and immediately wash your hands. Because if you did come in contact with pathogens, that would be a direct conduit for germs to enter the body. So if this made you feel afraid of sitting on a toilet, get over yourself. There's germs everywhere. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's episode of What the Facts. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, make sure you hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. Got a weird body science question? Shoot your shot, drop a comment below, and who knows, we might cover it. Be sure to catch more of this season every Tuesday.